Thanks for joining us for CBN News Midday. I'm Lee Webb.
And I'm Carolyn Castleberry. The first batches of the H1N1 flu vaccine have finally arrived, and just in time. The flu is expected to spread to every state in the next few days. Even so, many Americans say they're not worried about the flu, and they're not getting vaccinated. Here's reporter Paul Strand.
For weeks now, Americans have been debating whether or not to get the swine flu vaccine. Well, the time to decide is finally here, or will be in just the next few days. That's because about 7 million doses are being distributed across all the states this week, 40 million more by the middle of the month. Now, if you are going to get a dose, probably the sooner the better. Unlike the seasonal flu, which usually hits hardest in the winter, the swine flu has already made its way across all 50 states, especially since school's been back in session.
As a parent and as a pediatrician, if I can keep a child from getting an illness that will keep them out of school for 3, 5, 7 days, that's doing something.
I do want people to feel some sense of urgency about getting vaccinated. I think it's important. It's not something they should put off for 6 months.
Still, 6 out of 10 Americans aren't sure they're going to get vaccinated, and 4 out of 10 parents aren't sure they're going to get their kids vaccinated. Sometimes doctors are behind their doubts.
We don't know how well this works. We don't know how long it'll last. There's a lot of unknowns.
I don't think I'll get the swine flu vaccine. I'm not terribly concerned about getting the swine flu.
But many other doctors are urging Americans to get vaccinated and say they shouldn't worry about the vaccine.
This vaccine is produced exactly the way the annual seasonal vaccine is produced. We're very secure about how it was produced and how it was tested. This is a safe vaccine, and it's going to be very effective.
Paul Strand, CBN News, Washington.
3 Americans are sharing the honors when it comes to the 2009 Nobel Prize for Medicine. They're being honored for their research on cancer and aging. Elizabeth Blackburn, Carol Greider, and Jack Szostak. It's the first time 2 women have been among this category. The trio discovered how cells are protected at the DNA level when they divide. The hope now is to find a way to block the protective enzymes in cancerous cells and cause them to basically fall apart and be destroyed when they attempt to multiply.
The Supreme Court begins its new term today, and the first term for Justice Sonia Sotomayor. She'll have to take on 2 high-profile cases right away, a challenge to limits on corporate spending and political campaigns, and a lawsuit seeking to strike down handgun bans in the Chicago area. Court watchers will be looking to see how Sotomayor's personality affects the court and if her past as prosecutor makes her more sympathetic to law enforcement in criminal cases.
A setback today for breakaway Episcopal churches in California that want to keep their property. The Supreme Court has decided not to hear a case that pits St. James, a breakaway Newport Beach church, against its former denomination. Since trial proceedings are continuing in Orange County Court, the church's pastor says he's not surprised the Supreme Court refused the case. It is possible, though, St. James could appeal again with the U.S. Supreme Court, or the court may decide to hear another property challenge from pending cases in other states. And in another decision the Supreme Court made today, the court refused a pro-life group's request to review a federal appeals court's decision allowing states to ban pro-life messages on license plates.
As President Obama struggles with how to move forward in Afghanistan, this weekend America's military endured the deadliest day in more than a year. 8 U.S. soldiers were killed in a Saturday attack. Insurgents attacked 2 U.S. bases. And the news comes as a new U.S. policy calls for bases in some remote areas to be closed and for troops moved to more populated areas.
We must focus our resources and prioritize in those areas where the population's most threatened. We don't have enough forces to do everything everywhere at once.
We've had one lengthy meeting already last week with General McChrystal on the screen from Kabul. We will have more this week, 2 more meetings this week. So all of these things are being discussed as they should be against the backdrop of this unfortunate tragedy.
2 more NATO soldiers, including 1 American, are reportedly dead in the latest fighting in Afghanistan.
CBN News military reporter Chuck Holton joins us now by Skype with further insight on this outpost attack. Chuck, how could our troops have been overwhelmed and outnumbered in this kind of attack? And I guess give us an idea of how many troops or Marines may have been at this outpost.
Well, Lee, this outpost was the farthest northeast that U.S. troops have
maintained a presence so far in this war. It's in an area called Nuristan, which is incredibly mountainous and rugged. And it was really just a small outpost. It's called Fob Keating. These soldiers were actively engaged in trying to do humanitarian assistance, building, that sort of thing up there. But really, they've been in an area that has seen increasing numbers of Taliban and insurgents as the Pakistani army has gone into the Swat Valley and pushed a lot of those insurgents and Taliban across the border into Afghanistan. This is where they've taken refuge.
Chuck, do you think that General McChrystal's directive against the use of air support may have had anything to do with these deaths?
I don't, Lee. It sounds from the reports coming out of there that they did have air support, that they did have supporting fires, artillery, and mortars, and that sort of thing, but that they were just simply overwhelmed by a superior number of Taliban. And the Taliban paid a pretty high price, from what I understand, for that. But it sounds like Fob Keating was all but destroyed in this attack.
Chuck, how do you think this event will affect General McChrystal's request for more troops?
Boy, that's a tough question, Lee. I think that there are so many politics involved in that decision. And unfortunately, the way it's looking right now, the politics are going to play a bigger part than the realities on the ground. And I think that General McChrystal has taken the right strategy. He definitely needs a lot more troops, and he's trying to focus on providing security for as many Afghans as possible. And he's doing that by making the decision to pull back from these outposts in the middle of nowhere and secure the population centers where the largest number of people are. Unfortunately, I think it might even be a better idea to try and send our troops to where the enemy is, kill them off, and then we can worry about security.
One last quick question, Chuck. You served with General McChrystal when you were in the Army Rangers some years ago. If he should not receive a good answer, in his opinion, regarding the increase in forces in Afghanistan, is he the type of general that would resign?
You know, I think he is. I know that General McChrystal is an incredibly honorable man. He's a strong Christian believer. And, you know, he is going to stand by his principles. He always did, and I think he always will. I think probably more likely than him resigning, however, just given the politics and the charged environment in Washington, is that we may, at some point in the near future, see General McChrystal's character assassinated and see him drug over the coals, because he's making it very vocal. He's being very vocal about what needs to happen in order for us to win in Afghanistan. And that's kind of, you know, putting some pressure on the White House. And from what I understand, the White House doesn't like that very much.
Well, Chuck, as always, we appreciate your insights. Thanks for being with us.
My pleasure.
At least five people are dead after a suicide bomber blew himself up in the lobby of a United Nations building in Pakistan. The UN Secretary General has called the attack an unjustifiable, heinous crime. The blast happened at the headquarters for the World Food Program, and the death toll could increase. The explosion sent a number of people to the hospital with serious injuries. The WFP was distributing food to poor Pakistanis, including some who suffered loss in a recent Pakistan army battle against the militants in the Swat Valley.
Germany celebrated the 20th anniversary of the fall of the Berlin Wall Saturday with festivals, concerts, and parades, but also a little fear. Dale Hurd explains in this report.
In Berlin, tens of thousands watched a massive-scale street performance featuring a pair of giant marionettes made of wood and metal, suspended by cranes marching slowly through downtown. The spectacle, performed by France's Royal Deluxe Theatre Company, had the marionettes finding each other at the Brandenburg Gate, reuniting on the former dividing line between East and West Germany. At Germany's parliament, the Reichstag, crowds gathered to watch former Soviet leader Mikhail Gorbachev, the Soviet leader at the time of German reunification, plant a tree on the grounds in front of the building to mark the anniversary. Gorbachev says the final point of the Cold War was set here, but I have to tell you, we are still far from solving all the problems in Europe. The two Germanys were separated for more than four decades until the fall of the Berlin Wall in 1989 and official reunification in 1990. Security was tight in Berlin and across the country Saturday after a series of extremist Islamic videos were posted on the internet threatening Germany. Security has been very high in Munich at this year's Oktoberfest. Authorities have banned flights over the festival, and police have searched bags and cars as visitors arrived. This German says if something has to happen, it happens. With police, without police, with fear, without fear. Dale Hurd, CBN News.
Coming up, singing for Samoa. Members of this gospel choir lost family and friends in the tsunami. Now they're using their talents to help the survivors.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart.
These are the most powerful songs of our time. And now, for the first time, the biggest praise and worship songs are together.
How great is our God.
Presenting Songs for Worship 50. 50 songs in one specially priced collection.
Holy is the Lord God Almighty. The earth is filled.
You'll hear 50 beautiful songs of hope.
I'm coming back to the heart of worship. And it's
50 powerful songs of faith. Get Songs for Worship 50 on three CDs for only
$24.99. Here I am for worship. Here I am.
But wait, order in the next 10 minutes with your credit card and we'll take $15 off. That's right. You get 50 praise and worship songs for just
$9.99.
Then preview other great praise and worship collections. Satisfaction guaranteed.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
So call now and get Songs for Worship 50. 50 beautiful songs on three CDs for just $9.99.
Call 1-800-435-3414 to order Songs for Worship 50 on three CDs for $9.99 plus shipping and handling when you use your credit card. Call now or order online at timelife.com/songsforworship50.
In Indonesia, authorities now believe Wednesday's earthquake has killed thousands. Today, they called rescue workers off the search for life under the rubble. Over the weekend, aid workers reached remote areas and found evidence of landslides the quake triggered. In many places, the landslides have blocked roads and destroyed bridges. This church service provided relief for the people of Padang, heavily damaged by the quake. This man told a reporter, "My house is all destroyed, but I still devote myself to going to church because the only one who can give us happiness is God."
Worshippers gathered at a church in the U.S. territory of American Samoa on Sunday for a national prayer service there following last week's devastating tsunami. Worshippers from various denominations met at the Congregational Christian Church of Samoa to remember victims of the tsunami that tore through their homeland. Prayer and songs of worship filled the church as an encouragement to those who lost loved ones in the disaster.
Faith is most important. It's the very basis by which these communities are rooted and rooted. And I believe this is probably the reason why also the community has decided to come together for this prayer service.
The tsunami killed 135 people in Samoa, including 32 in American Samoa and 9 in nearby Tonga.
Meanwhile, here in the U.S., one of Christian music's most celebrated groups, the Katinas, will hold a benefit concert to help raise money for the tsunami-hit region. The Katinas, an a cappella singing group, claim Samoa as their native homeland. They lost both family and friends in the disaster. The concert, called Hope for Samoa Benefit Concert, is set for Wednesday, October 7th. Christian artist Natalie Grant and American Idol's Melinda Doolittle are set to join the group for that concert.
And joining us now to talk about fundraising efforts for the victims of the Samoan tsunami are James and John Katina, two of the five brothers who make up the popular Christian band Katina that we were just talking about. We'll start with you, John. Your band has had a personal connection in this tragedy. Tell us a little bit about that.
Yes, thank you so much for having us. Our hearts are going out to our people right now. About a week ago, they suffered, which is probably the greatest catastrophe to ever hit our island, both Samoa's and also the island, Kingdom Island of Tonga. And we're in mourning with our people, but you know, we just thank God for His grace, and we know that ultimately He is in control. And there's been an overwhelming response of love, prayers, and just support from the people of God. And it's been amazing to see how the body of Christ has literally been the hands and feet of Jesus to reach our people.
Amen. Amen. Well, James, you guys are organizing a big fundraiser concert for this week. Tell us a little bit about that.
Yes, we are. We're very excited about our first of probably several benefit concerts that we'll be doing throughout the U.S., Hope for Samoa. We'll be joined by dear friends of ours, Michael W. Smith, Anthony Grant, Jeremy Camp, the Doolittle. So this will be a great effort to raise funds that is ongoing even now. We are going. We actually planned a missions trip to go back to Samoa in November. Well, obviously the mission has changed a little. It'll be more of a relief effort, and we'll still be doing concerts, but a lot of money that we've been raising is going directly to the victims there and to relief. It'll be Wednesday, October 7th, Fellowship Bible Church.
All right, John, how can folks get involved even if they can't attend the concert? And we do apologize for any dropouts we're having in our audio, but we do want to get this information on. Tell us about that.
Yes, if you can't be there in person, you can go to katinamissions.org. That's katinamissions.org. And any donation for any amount is just greatly appreciated. And then there's other people who want to join us in person and provide medical services or construction help to rebuild some of the buildings and churches that have been devastated.
All right. Well, God is good. Your audio's back. So one more question for you. Any specific prayer requests for your homeland that we can join you in praying?
Obviously, the prayer that's needed there is not only for the physical needs and the emotional needs, but I think spiritually, we really feel like God is using this to bring an awakening. We've been hearing testimonies of people renewing their faith in the Lord, and that's what we're believing. As we go, we're believing for an opportunity to proclaim the love of Jesus. It's the love of Jesus that compels people to a knowledge of Jesus Christ, and that's exciting. So pray for that. Pray for our missions trip this coming November.
All right, very good. Thank you so much for stopping by to talk to us. We appreciate it. James and John Katina, and we'll be praying for you as well.
And you know, Carolyn, we've talked already in this newscast about the earthquake in Indonesia, mm-hmm. the Samoan tsunami, but we haven't talked about the Philippines yet. Right. But the battered Philippines took another hit this weekend as Typhoon Parma struck the island of Luzon. Flooding and landslides killed 16 people there.
Nevertheless, the people of Manila are relieved that Parma didn't dump more rain on the city. The capital's still recovering from floods caused by Typhoon Katsana, which hit last week. George Thomas has this report from Manila.
In Pasig, one of the hardest hit districts of Metro Manila, there are signs this Monday that life is slowly returning to normal. A week after floods from Typhoon Katsana left nearly 300 dead and reduced wide swaths of the capital to ruins, residents in Pasig are picking up the pieces. Kids are heading back to school. Garbage is being collected. The water is back on, and businesses are clearing and cleaning up.
Yes, trying to recover everything that we lost.
And at the corner of Paseo de Animals and Gabriel Street in Pasig, Sola Gracia Baptist Church opened its doors on Sunday for the very first time since the storm hit. The church has been on this corner for nearly 20 years. Last Saturday, when the typhoon came ashore, the entire neighborhood went under.
We are used to getting flood waters that reach to our thighs, but this time it was over 2 meters above the roof of the church. Just look around. This place is a mess. The road is destroyed, so people have to walk through all this mud. I've never seen such destruction.
Despite the obvious inconveniences of trying to hold Sunday service in a place like this, mounds of trash as far as the eye can see, water all over the place, people trying to rebuild their homes. For Pastor Cirilla, it was an important message to send to this devastated community.
We had to open the church. We had to tell people that God is alive, that He cares for them and loves them in the midst of their suffering.
Many other areas in Manila and nearby eastern provinces remain flooded. Typhoon Katsana dumped a month's worth of rainfall in just 6 hours. Nearly 400,000 displaced people are still living in evacuation centers like this one. This weekend, CBN's Operation Blessing International deployed teams of doctors to some of the hardest hit areas, while other Operation Blessing teams rolled up their sleeves and cooked hot meals for children. It capped off a week of ministering by Operation Blessing to over 64,000 victims of Typhoon Katsana. And it is just the beginning. This coming week, Operation Blessing disaster relief teams head to villages that have yet to be reached with desperate supplies like food, water, and medical attention. George Thomas, CBN News, Manila.
Up next, Building the Kingdom, why the recession hasn't hurt this church construction firm.
Israel, the land where God came to mankind. Imagine to be in the place where our Lord lived, to stand where He performed His miracles, to see where He taught the multitudes. The pages of the Bible come alive in the land filled with God's promises. Don't miss this experience of a lifetime. Visit Israel. You'll never be the same.
Call today.
Each week, thousands of concerned parents and grandparents start Globe Young American plans for their children and grandchildren. The Young American Plan is a simple, affordable way to secure valuable life insurance protection. Starting a Young American Plan today guarantees the future insurability of your loved ones. Once issued, the Young American Plan can never be canceled. For just $1, you can start a Young American Plan and feel safe knowing you've provided your child or grandchild with a lifetime of protection. The regular premium you establish now is guaranteed to never increase. And the Young American Plan builds cash value that can be used in the future. Since 1964, millions of concerned parents and grandparents have started Globe Young American Plans for their children and grandchildren. Call Globe today.
Call right now for complete information about the Globe Young American Plan. Call Globe today at 1-800-457-4154.
Israel, the land where God came to mankind. Imagine to be in the place where our Lord lived, to stand where He performed His miracles, to see where He taught the multitudes. The pages of the Bible come alive in the land filled with God's promises. Don't miss this experience of a lifetime. Visit Israel. You'll never be the same.
Call today.
Many companies have had to close their doors because of the bad economy.
Despite the recession, one church construction company has actually doubled its business. Heather Sells has that story.
It's a privilege. I'm humbled by the fact that I get to do this.
Glenn Trematori's career has taken him from Wall Street to his own startup, Church Development Services. The mission, help churches expand their physical facilities.
It's hard to imagine a church construction company growing in these tough economic times, but that's exactly what Church Development Services has done. Last year, they did about $4 million worth of construction. This year, they expect $7 million.
They're taking some risk. They are taking some risk. They're looking past the fear and God's blessing that.
Trematori says there's no one reason why his company is so busy these days, but churches like Pine Grove Baptist can help explain. This small country church knew it needed to expand.
Folks aren't going to sit elbow to elbow for an extended period of time without something on the horizon taking place.
So Pine Grove took a leap of faith, hiring Glenn's firm and waiting to see how God would work. Miracle number one, selling its old church at market price in a depressed real estate market. It's what Trematori calls God's economy.
Someone will step in the gap. There'll be an unexpected gift. It could be a gift of labor. It could be a gift of money.
Church Development Services offers low-cost building plans, and it offers expertise in creative financing, including access to private equity. That's helping churches expand that would otherwise be unable.
Right now, it's the financial component. It's not the health of the church. I think the church is awesome. It's the fact that the banking system really took a hit in September of 08, and as a result of that, they're unable to make the loans they would otherwise make.
So thanks to this financial know-how, faith, and the mysteries of God's economy, churches like Pine Grove are springing up across the country. They're pointing their communities to the power of God and finding their own faith strengthened as well.
They've seen where faith does pay off. It's real. When you trust God, He's going to provide your needs.
If God's put on your heart to expand your church, and if you're growing, if He's bringing people to your door, then I would say, you know, move forward.
In Petersburg, Virginia, Heather Sells, CBN News.
Love to shop for shoes, but there's no place to store them? You're always running out of room to store more. Introducing Shoes Under, the easy solution to organize and protect your shoes. The clear zipper cover locks out dust and moisture. Now you just slide and store. It's that easy. With two handles, you can easily store your shoes here, under there, almost everywhere, and turn an empty space into a super storage place. Other shoe organizers can cost a fortune, but through this exclusive television offer, you can get the 12-compartment Shoes Under for only $19.99. Call now and we'll cut that price in half. That's right, for only $10. And as a bonus, we'll double the offer and give you a second Shoes Under that's enough space for 48 shoes. Just pay separate shipping and handling. Call now and get two Shoes Under for only $10.
Call 1-800-943-1652. You'll get a second one free, so call 1-800-943-1652. That's 1-800-943-1652. Call now.
They're calling it the biggest baby boom since the first Gulf War at Cape Fear, North Carolina.
527 babies were born in September alone at the medical center there. The reason? Well, the military connection. Doctors say there's always a minor population explosion 9 months after big homecomings, but this one averages out to about 17 babies per day. That kept the staff hopping.
It's been nonstop. You go from one room to another room, and it's been a lot of fun, very exciting, very challenging, very tiring.
Not all the babies born last month have that military connection, though. And would you believe that this is not a record? Doctors say their biggest month was January 1992. Back then, the hospital nursery was filled with 558 babies. Where do you think they put all those babies?
That's a good question. You know, and I guess that was right after the first Gulf Wars. That explains it.
But, exactly.
Well, good for them. Finally today, earlier you met the Katinas, the a cappella choir from American Samoa that's raising money to help victims of the tsunami there.
We thought we'd sign off today by letting you hear a little bit more of their music, and we'll see you tomorrow. Enjoy.
Fresh, wholesome juice. There's nothing like it. But until now, you had to stress and strain and make a huge mess to get just a little bit of juice. But not anymore, thanks to the Jack LaLanne Power Juicer. You can drop in whole vegetables, whole fruits, apples, oranges, celery, cucumbers with no chopping, no slicing, no struggling. And thanks to the Power Juicer's revolutionary patented extraction technology, you can get up to 30% more juice than those other juicers. Doctors recommend we get 5 to 9 servings of fruits and vegetables every day. With the Power Juicer, you'll be drinking your recommended daily allowance
allowance in just seconds. And the pulp from the extra large pulp catcher can be used to make pasta sauces, healthy desserts, and much more. The power juicer is dishwasher safe, so cleanup's a breeze, and the powerful motor is guaranteed for life. Order the Jack LaLanne power juicer now for just two easy payments of $49.90. And as part of this special TV offer, we'll also send you this amazing recipe guide filled with over 60 of Jack's favorite recipes. Try the Jack LaLanne power juicer in your home risk-free for 30 days. If you're not completely satisfied, send it back for a full refund of the purchase price, no questions asked. Call now.